spores.
Yo, what is up there, guys? It's Mr. Jackin' In, and we are playing Hearthstone today. That is right. Gonna be opening up packs. That is all that this video is. Just me opening packs. Now, I've actually recorded these visually on a separate date. I'm just doing a little bit of audio over them because I couldn't wait to open the packs and too busy playing to actually record the audio over. So figured I'd just make one nice video of all the packs being opened up here. So you can see we got a nice Paladin card, Repentance. Eviscerate for the Rogue, Thoughtsteal for the Priest, that's a pretty good card. Warlock, the Summoning Portal, that's also a pretty damn good card. And Siphon Soul, which is another awesome card for Warlock. So some pretty good cards in that pack. I can say this in hindsight, knowing which cards have been useful to me and which ones haven't. If you want to read a lot of the text and the flavor stuff, you're free to, you know, pause the video and really look at them. But I would just suggest, you know, maybe watching some more of the other Hearthstone videos where I actually use the cards in up and coming videos. Yeah, that's probably the best way you'll get to learn to identify some of these cards. All right, and there's the one legendary card, the Alarmabot. That's an interesting card now because it's interesting. The way it works is like essentially you put it on the field, and then if it survives one full turn, it switches out with another card in your hand. You don't lose him, he just goes back to your hand, they swap places. And that could be really good, but it can also be really ineffective. So it's kind of fun. I've actually used it against one of my friends. There's this giant dragon card called Ysera, and I played the Alarmobot, and he let it go through, and I had two cards in my hand. And Ysera, like I said, is a big dragon guy, but so that instantly means it's a really good card. We got Ysera out, and he was just dumbstruck, so it was pretty funny. Pretty darn funny. Or no, it wasn't Ysera, it was Prophet Velen, which is a pretty sick card. And I was playing a priest, obviously, because that's a priest card. A very powerful one. Alright, so we're getting some Shaman cards. Shield Bear, that's another pretty awesome card. It's got Taunt, 4 HP, and it only costs 1 mana, so I like that. Dark Iron Dwarf's pretty fun, too. And a Void Tear, which is a pretty good card. Forked Lightning is actually pretty good for the Shamans too, if you're playing an Overlord-centric or Overload-centric style. Some of these mechanics in some of the videos I haven't really explored, you'll see in the upcoming videos that I go into a little bit more detail into what those different mechanics are within the game. All right, so we got the Argent Protector. He's pretty good. Redemption, just a spell card. Mana Worm, an awesome card. Acolyte of Pain's a pretty good card, and Imp Master, an alright card. So we're getting a wide variety, just getting new cards incorporated into our constructed decks, which is always awesome to do. Let's just practice and whatnot, and to beat up on our friends. So you see this pack now, we got a lot more. We got some epic cards in here, a couple rares, and a common card. Now, I believe I actually ended up purchasing two packs, because when you make a purchase, you actually get a free gold card as well, so I just wanted to make the smallest purchase I could. What I've noticed is that you'll see, and then the next pack as well is one of the two packs I purchased, and you'll see that like the quality of cards seems to be a lot greater than the ones that than the cards that I got from the arena. I'm not saying that this is 100% true, not like you can't get legendaries or epic, but you look at that, I got that was a legendary, and that's the only card I got. So I don't know if that last pack I just got happened to be exceptionally stellar, and then the one after this also happened to just have a really nice legendary card, but these were the two packs I bought. And the other ones I've only gotten four common cards and then a rare. Alright, there's Prophet Velen, the card I was talking about. Look at that. Double the damage and healing powers of your spells and hero power. It's a great priest card. Especially that with the Northshire Cleric and just tons of buffs. It's some pretty crazy stuff. Alright. A Leper Gnome. He of the Gnomish Kind. Another Repentance. Now we got two for the Paladin deck if we wanted to go a little secret heavy. Cult Master is a pretty nice card. Now Argent Commander. He's got Charge and Divine Shield. Makes him pretty useful at taking down some necessary targets. That Divine Shield can just let him tank some massive hits. Alright. Battle Rage for the Warrior. Silence for the Priest. Zero mana cards, pretty nice. Sense of Demons for Warlock, that's pretty good. Put two random demons. Especially with that Void Terror, you can use that to to get it. It means to nom on. Alright. Well, that seems to end it here for the opening of cards. Thank you so much for watching. This is probably like the best part of watching Hearthstone is people opening cards, card packs. So that's why I wanted to make sure I recorded them and was able to let you guys see. So thank you so much for watching, and like always, this is InfestedMothership checking out. Peace.